only when I am working with my disciples and they don't listen to me, I remember how much I tortured my gurus by my disobedience. She will work almost 4-5 hours and make that aushadha that is supposed to be drunk, taken when it is hot, and I'll take few sips and start throwing tantrum. Oh, it is too hot. You are forcing me to drink this. But on good thing, very good thing, I can't run away from them. Simply she'll slap. She'll just slap me and Isaki Swami will hold my mouth and Narayana Swami Tata will pour that aushadha into my mouth. And no, that was really, I had one fortune. Neither I can run away, escape from them, nor my parents will. There is no question of running away from them. There is no question of escaping from them. Even that idea is wrong. Idea does not exist. She is my grandmother also. Not just my guru. My grandmother also. In a way, relative. And ultimately, palar. Just, she will slap and I will have to open my mouth and they will pour the whole thing. Now, I feel blessed. I had gurus who had complete power over me, authority over me. Annamalayani, piravamai vendum, oru velai pirandal, unai maravamai vendum, idupol, en meedhu mulu urimaiyum kondu, என்னை முழுமையாக்குகின்ற ஞான குருமார்கள் அடிவாழ வேண்டும். A kind of the right they had over me. The modern day, now I will never utter a word about Arunachala's ecosystem. Mahadeva is very possessive of Arunachala. I won't utter. Maybe in other places, I don't know how many disciples have this kind of a commitment to the guru. Not only disciple, the whole family of the disciple, the whole ecosystem. See, it's not that only I was committed. My parents were absolutely committed to my gurus. The whole ecosystem was committed. Fortunately, in those days, the stupid POSCO law and all was not there. The original India, before this anti-Hindu terrorist could destroy the Gurukul lifestyle using all kinds of defamation law, everything. All right, I won't get into that side as on now. Let me talk only about the positive side. One thing I can tell you. Hinduism did not die when the temples were destroyed. Hinduism did not die when all our wealth was robbed, stolen, taken to England. But Hinduism is getting destroyed when the Gurukul system is getting destroyed.